Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up, I'm going to give you a hands-on tour of Microsoft Search, your tailored search experience for information in your organization to find people, files, org charts, sites, and answers to common questions. We'll explain what Microsoft Search is and how it works, how you can set it up quickly and tap into advanced capabilities to help your users find the information they need to get work done. And I'm going to start by showing you the user experience for Microsoft Search. So right now I've got Microsoft Edge open. I'm going to search directly in the address bar, in this case for an internal site. So we'll go ahead and search for HR. So what that's going to do is it's going to show me the human resources site right there in the context of all the other search results. And when I click into that, of course, I can get to my HR internal sites for human resources. Now I'm going to actually open up another tab and I'm going to show you how you can actually search for Q&A straight from the address bar as well. So in my case, I've got a question about 401ks. When I do that, it gives me an answer to that question right within the search results. And when I click on it, I can go straight to the benefits site for Contoso. Now, but search goes beyond the sites, and I can even look for people that I work with. So I'm going to here, in this case, look for Adele Vance, a colleague of mine. So I'm going to go ahead and type Adele Vance right in the address bar, and you can see she comes up. Then I can even look at Adele's organization, files that we've worked on, groups, and even meetings that we have together in the future. So in the overview, I can even look at her office location and search for that. And when I do that, it brings up a floor plan of her office, in this case, Millennium 1260. But if I don't know where Millennium is, I can even get a map to how to drive to Millennium. So I'll do that here in this case. And you'll see that it gives me a nice big map that I can expand out. If I want to get directions, I can do that to be able to get to the Millennium building. Now for new employees, or if you're new to a topic, it's often hard to understand acronyms, especially for non-public acronyms. So I'm going to show you something that I named actually a few years back, or helped name. So I'm going to search for what is MDT. Now here you can see Contoso has configured MDT, Microsoft Deployment Toolkit, as an acronym, because obviously they know how to deploy operating systems, and they have everything there easily discoverable for their employees. Now this experience also equates to files that are located across OneDrive and SharePoint. Let me show you how that works in another tab. So here I'm going to go ahead and look for files about marketing. So we can see here that all the different files from Contoso Electronics for marketing comes up in the search results. And I can even click on this new work vertical that gives me all of the different search results that are scoped exactly to Contoso Electronics, all the files as well as people, groups, sites, and conversations. And let me show you an interactive experience integrated with Power Apps and Microsoft Search. So in my case, I'm going to search for a time card. So I'll do a search for the word time card. And I want to actually lodge some out of office time. So that's going to bring up a Power App. Now when I launch that Power App right here from within Search, I can create the out of office message. So I need to specify the dates, the type of travel, the connectivity, and who to contact while I'm away. So we'll add Adele. And what that will do is actually generate the email for me that's going to go both inside or outside my org if I decide I want to. When I click submit, it's ready and it will start sending out of office replies straight from within Power Apps from within Microsoft Search. Everything I just showed you on the PC can be done on my phone in the Edge browser once I'm signed in. Let me show you how this works. So here on my phone, I'll open up Edge. I'm going to paste in Millennium. Now when I do that, you'll see the same results like we saw on the PC with a nice map here. And if I want to add the office number, let's say I want to find the office for Adele, I can do that here and I can even click in and expand the map and be able to navigate that building just with my phone. And by the way, all of this works in Google Chrome as well. Let me show you. So in my case, I'm going to search for another colleague of mine, Nestor Wilk. So here, when I do that, it has the same view like we saw in Microsoft Edge. Everything that I could do there, even like clicking on the work vertical, I can see here as well. Now the nice thing, even though this is in Chrome, I can still decide which search engine I want to use as a user. So I can toggle that control right here. So that was the user experience. Let me explain how this works on the search and device sides. So the Microsoft Search service is pulling its information from the Microsoft Graph. This includes services like SharePoint, OneDrive, Teams, and Yammer, as well as organizational and directory service information. Now, the graph also helps with relevancy and recency. So if you're looking for something that has a similar or has duplicate results, it can surface what you're looking for. And the results are surfaced in a page that uses Bing to rank and render the results. Now, on the device side, you have two primary options. First, with the new Microsoft Edge browser, everything you need is built in. Second, for Google Chrome, there's a package that you deploy that will run a background service. Now, this package is also included in newer versions of Microsoft 365 apps for Enterprise. The background service regularly calls the Microsoft Search backend, and it's looking to see if you've enabled the Microsoft Search in Bing setting. And if enabled, it automatically installs the Chrome extension and sets Bing as the default search engine. Now let me show you how you can get all of this up and running. I'll start with the configuration at the client endpoint. Ideally here, you would deploy the Microsoft Edge browser, which has the prerequisites all included by default. In fact, we just published a step-by-step for how to do this at aka.ms/edgeforit. Now you can also use Google Chrome as mentioned, and these steps only apply to that browser, but are defaults again in the new Microsoft Edge browser. For Chrome, you'll provision the browser extension needed, and you can do that by downloading it aka.ms/searchmsi and distributing the MSI package using your preferred tooling, like Microsoft Endpoint Manager, as you can see here. And this will allow your browser to check if you've configured Microsoft Search in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. And again, if you're using Office 365 Pro Plus, or also known as Microsoft 365 Apps for Enterprise, this capability is native to anything from the May 2020 monthly channel and newer. So now with all the prerequisites in place, you can opt into the service in the Microsoft Search Admin Center. What that's going to do is actually set the default search engine in Chrome for managed computers to Bing for Microsoft Search in order to work highly integrated so you can search directly from the address bar as you saw before. Now with all the endpoint configurations in place, we can move on to the rest of the controls in the Microsoft Search Admin Center. First, let me show you how to find it. So if you expand out Show All, then go to All Admin Centers, you'll see Microsoft Search. Now once you're there, it's going to show you insights about previous searches and search activities in your organization. And I'm going to start with acronyms. Now here you can see some of the acronyms like MDT that we showed earlier. I'm going to show you how to add another acronym. In my case, I want to add MSI. So I have already in the clipboard a description for that MSI. And from there, I can actually copy and paste out its expansion, which is Microsoft Windows Installer. Once finished, I can add the source URL for this. And when I click Publish, it's ready to be searched. Now in bookmarks, you can define primary internal and external sites, line of business apps, and services that your users are going to search for. Now here we can see a collection of bookmarks that we've already defined and some that we demonstrated earlier. Now I'm going to show you how to add one. So in my case, I actually have a site that I want to add in bookmarks. So what I'm going to do here is go out of full screen in the browser. I'm going to then grab the address for this site, which is the Contoso Learn site. Now we'll click Add. Then we're going to give this a title, Contoso Learn. We'll paste in our URL that we copied earlier. We'll add a description. Then we'll enter some keywords. Now here I can use reserved keywords that make sure that they find this page when searching for words like learn and train as defined here. And these will win if you have any conflicts. I can also set the dates when I want to start the site, countries and regions where it's relevant, groups that should be able to find that, device types that are relevant, and also the Power App that we saw earlier. We can add one here if we want to, simply by grabbing the Power App app ID and then defining the width and height in pixels. Once I've done all of that, I can click Publish, and it's ready for people to start looking for that bookmark for Contoso Learn. So let's move on to locations in floor plans. A couple things to remember here. So I'm going to start with floor plans. Floor plans are predicated on your location, so you actually need to start with floor plans in the Locations tab and import or enter the different locations that you have. So here I've got my four locations included with Contoso Electronics. I'm going to add one more location. So we're going to give first our building a name. We'll call it Building 1. We'll give it a country, United States. Paste in the address. Then we'll give it keywords. In this case, we'll add campus. And we'll click Publish. Now this will take around 24 hours or so for everything to get processed on the back end. Now I'm ready if I want to, once I've done all of that, to add the floor plans themselves. So let me show you how that works. So here in floor plans, I've already got one published that we saw earlier. But to add one, what we have to do is first select the building where we want to add it. We'll select the Commons in this case, and we'll click Next. Now we have to upload a DWG file. Now this is a graphical representation of the floor plan. So we're going to navigate to our DWG file. We will then define which floor that DWG file is for. It's a flat two-dimensional file. Then we have to map it back to our Azure Active Directory. In our case, it's for building 12. And what that's going to do is actually find all the matches from the DWG file against all the different people that are in Azure AD with that building 12 location. So once we're ready to publish, we can do that now. In my case, I've done that with this DWG file for Millennium, so I'm going to cancel out. So now we're ready to go. And locations, as I mentioned earlier, are part of what feeds into those floor plans. Next, we're going to add Q&As, just like we saw earlier with the 401k example. So to do that, we're going to click into Q&A. And you can see here that I've got four different Q&As already predefined. You see the 401k Q&A that we saw earlier. I'm going to add a new one, though. So in my case, I want to add a Q&A about learning, as we saw with the earlier Learn site. So I'll add the question, where can I find training? We'll add the URL that we added earlier with our Learn site, and we'll add a description. Now here I can again define keywords and other attributes. So we'll add some keywords. And if I wanted to, I could specify, for example, the device and OS that I want to, or any variations that I might have for different languages or different locations. Now I have the Q&A ready for people to start searching for. Now, all of what I showed in the beginning is configured. Once users start to search, you'll be able to get insights on common searches and queries to inform how you can make your configurations even better and more relevant. That was a quick review of your options to get Microsoft Search up and running. To learn more, check out aka.ms/Microsoft Search for more information, and check out our Microsoft Edge and Search playlist at aka.ms/Edge for IT. Thanks for watching.